Hi guys! Welcome sa Engineered Math Channel. Sa video na to ay ituturo ko sa inyo ang exponent. So kung gusto niyo itong matutunan, just keep on watching. So basically, exponents ay mahalagang concept sa mathematics na madalas nating gamitin, particularly sa algebra, sa algebraic expressions and polynomials. So, mahalaga na dapat alam natin yung concept nito. So, let's start with the definitions and terms that we encounter when we deal with exponents. So, let's say we have the expression or the equation 2 to the 4th power is equal to 16. So, dito sa equation na to, which is 2 to the 4th power is equal to 16, ito ay example ng exponential equation. Kasi meron tayong exponent, meron tayong base, at meron tayong power. So, ano ba yung exponent, base, at power natin dito? So, basically, yung 2, siya yung ating base. At yung 4, siya yung exponent. 16, siya yung power. So, pag may nakita kayong isang number na naka-raise sa isang number, yun agad ay exponent. So, ano ba definition ng exponent? So, an exponent tells how many times you will multiply the base by itself. So, in this case, since ang base natin ay 2 at ang exponent natin ay 4, ibig sabihin nito, imumultiply natin yung 2 ng 4 na beses sa kanyang sarili. So, kaya, we have 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 is equal to 16. At yun yung power natin na 16. So, that's the concept of exponents. So, we have the base, the exponent, and the power. And the exponent ay nagtetell sa atin kung ilang beses natin imumultiply yung base natin sa kanyang sarili para makuha yung isang power. Okay. With this concept, pwede ngayon tayo mag-evaluate ng sample about exponents. So, for example, we have 3 to the 4th power. So, again, this is an example of exponent. We have the base 3 and exponent of 4. So, applying the definition of exponent, we have to multiply the base 3 by itself 4 times. So, we have 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 is equal to 81. How about negative 2 quantity raised to the 5th power? So, this time, we have the base of negative 2, which is raised to the 5th power. So, take note, yung negative 2 ay naka-enclose sa parenthesis, which means, ang base natin ay negative 2, hindi positive 2. So, therefore, kasama siya sa imumultiply natin 5 times sa sarili, including nga yung negative niya. So, minsan kasi nagkakamali yung mga tao dito. So, we have negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2. So, we have to multiply negative 2 by itself 5 times and we get the answer of negative 32. Okay, let's try another example. Let's have 1/2 raised to the 3rd power. So, this time, ang base natin ay 1/2. So, therefore, imumultiply natin yung base na 1/2 by itself 3 times since ang exponent natin ay 3. So, we have 1/2 times 1/2 times 1/2. So, we have 1 times 1 times 1 is 1 over 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. How about 3 to the 2nd power over 4 to the 3rd power? So this time, meron tayong fraction at yung numerator at denominator ay may exponent. So we have to evaluate each numerator and denominator. So for the numerator, we have 3 to the 2nd power is equal to 3 times 3. And for the denominator, we have 4 to the 3rd power, which is equal to 4 times 4 times 4. So therefore, our final answer is 9 over 64. So likewise, kung meron kang expression such as 5 times 5 times 5 times 5 times 5, pwede mo siyang i-convert into exponential form by simply checking kung ano ba yung minumultiply natin ng ilang beses sa sarili niya, which is 5. So that is the base. Kung ilang beses siya minultiply sa sarili niya, so bilangan natin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have exponent of 5. So therefore, it is equal to 3,125. Now, let's try to consider the special cases for exponents. So let's have the 0 and negative exponent. So for the 0 exponent, it just states that when you have a base, let's say x, and you raise it to the 0 power, it is always equal to 1. So that is the 0 exponent. So kahit anong base mo, kahit anong number mo, basta ni-raise mo sa 0, laging ang sagot ay 1. For example, we have 35 raised to the 0 power. Dahil naka-raise nga siya sa 0, laging sagot ay 1. Or kahit gaano pa kalaki yan, let's say 125,386,791 raised to the 0 power. So kahit gaano pa kalaki yan, basta ni-raise mo sa 0, automatic sagot ay 1. Now let's try to have the negative exponent. So let's say we have a base x and raise it to a negative exponent, let's say negative n. It is equal to 1 over x raised to n. So basically, kung meron kang negative exponent, ang gagawin mo lang, magiging fraction siya. Yung numerator ay 1 at yung denominator ay yung same base mo at yung exponent mo ay magiging positive na. For example, 2 to the negative 3 power. So, kung i-apply natin yung law na to, which is the negative exponent, magkakaroon tayo ng numerator na 1 over yung base na 2 magiging denominator. And then, yung exponent na negative 3, pag nilagay mo na siya sa denominator, magiging positive na siya. So, 1 over 2 to the 3rd power. I-evaluate na natin, we have 1 over 2 times 2 times 2, which is equal to 1 over 8. Okay, another example. We have negative 3, quantity raised to the negative 2. Okay, take note ulit dun sa negative sign. So, kasama yung negative sign sa base na 3. So, we have applying the law for negative exponent, we have 1 over, copy yung base na negative 3, and then yung exponent na 2, which is magiging positive na, kasi nasa denominator na. So therefore, it is equal to 1 over negative 3 times negative 3, or 1 over 9. Okay? So, that is all about exponents. So, basically, the exponent tells you how many times you will multiply the base by itself to obtain a power. And then, for zero exponents, any number raised to zero is equal to 1. And for the negative exponent, apply nyo lang yung law na magiging fraction siya. Let's say you have a base x raised to negative n, it is equal to 1 over x raised to n. So sana ay may natutunan kayo sa video na to at maraming salamat sa panonood.